Dog is Family on Berks Community Television is underwritten by Answers Pet Food.
Hi, folks. Thank you for joining us on our show, Dog is Family, where we celebrate the bond between people and their dogs, where we talk about all kinds of things that we can do to enhance our lives. And right now, during COVID and the pandemic, it's time to, for many of us, to reflect on how we're living with our dogs, what we can do together. I know some folks struggle with training and all kinds of things, but it's also a time to reflect and to look at our lives and to think about how we can do different things in our lives. And my name is Barb Emmett. I'm your host and producer for this show. And I also am the co-owner of Godfrey's Welcome to Dogdom, where we do all kinds of things to enhance mind, body, and spirit. Because you know what? Dogs are a family. And that is the name of this show. And I also like to explore people whose lives have changed as a result of having a dog. Many of us talk about how our lives are enhanced and we go down different paths. I know for me, I did. I was in IT, information technology, and started volunteering for a local rescue group with golden retrievers and having a dog in my 40s and fell in love. And many lessons came to me from all of that experience. And it led me to open a business. It led me to work on a business plan, open a business, and start on a whole different path for my passion. And today, I am excited to welcome a woman who has been doing this her whole life, following her passion and changing her life. And I hope that a lot of what she shares with you folks today can be inspiring for you as well. Because after all, it's who touches who in this world, whose relationships change you, how you become different. And she's got some wonderful dogs here. Let's welcome Deborah Deeken. Hi, Deborah.
Hi, Barb.
I am delighted to have you on the show. Deborah is an artist, an illustrator, and a retired art teacher. And look who's with you.
Yeah, I don't think they're staying long. This is Stella, and she's very shy, and I'm not sure she's going to stay with us long. And this is Kizzy. Stella is a rescue from a puppy mill, and Kizzy is 10 months old.
Very
responsible breeder.
Uh-huh.
Stella's not happy because her brother's not here right now. So I think she's going to cut out now. You say goodbye.
Bye, Stella. You are a sweet little girl.
And we're very sweet girl.
See you.
And they are the inspirations. The book I'm working on currently is about Stella. And Stella and Kizzy debuted in my most recently published book. So
yeah, we titled this segment, Deborah and I, My Dog Made Me Do It, which, boy, there's a lot of meaning behind that one. She is bringing her artistic skills to bring joy to children and author and illustrator, and she's got tons of books. We're going to be talking about each one of those today. Her dog made her do it. Now, in all of our lives, we have different phases. You know, sometimes we're propelled to do something different. Let's get your little bit of life story here, Deborah. Please lead us on to who you are today and how you got there.
Okay, so Barb, the one thing we were discussing was following your passion and not stopping yourself from doing things that you feel so strongly about. And briefly, I said when I graduated from high school, I wanted to be an art teacher, and I was told, you can't do that. Not that I personally couldn't do it, but you'll never get a job. So I wound up doing something that I taught history, which was good, but it wasn't what I truly wanted to do. And I did that for about half my career. And then I decided, you know what, I'm going to be an art teacher. And I took a sabbatical. I took 47 credits from summer to summer. And even when I was trying to do that, I had school after school, university after university say, you can't get there from here, because I didn't have the DFA. And at Moore College of Art and Design, they said, I'm going to help you. I'm going to help you do that. So one non-dream squasher. And so worked very hard and finally got to where I wanted to be. And I love teaching art, especially elementary school art to kids. They're wonderful. So that was a great Love the first half, love the second half of teaching to the little kids. So, dream squashers. So then when I decide, well, what am I going to do when I retire? And brainstormed all these ideas of things I could do with dogs or art or both, and had this long list. And at the bottom, it was like, write and illustrate children's picture books. And for a possibility of actually doing it, I had zero. Mm-hmm. I had zero on that. And when telling the story I just told you, after telling that to someone, I reflected back on that because I was very tenacious when I went back and got that art certificate. And I said, who's telling me now that I can't write these books? And I realized it was me.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that tenacity that I had to get to where I wanted to be when I wanted to be an art teacher, I said, well, I'm the only one saying, I call them head bullies. I credit that to a dear man, Curtis Childs from my church. Head bullies, you know, were stopping me from doing what I wanted to do. And so from then on, people said, what are you doing now that you're retired? I said, I'm an author illustrator of children's picture books.
You set your intention. Yes.
I set that intention. I made that declaration. And from there on, I started writing children's picture books. And when I do presentations at school, that's one of the messages I say to the children is, don't be an obstacle for yourself, you know, don't bully yourself, don't keep yourself from trying new things, and follow what you're passionate about, feel strongly about.
That's so inspiring. And along the way, obviously, the artwork that you've produced, whether it mixed media and on the canvases, we see a framed piece behind you and another piece on canvas. So all along the way, you've been doing, I'm sure, all kinds of art, but certainly the dog themed came up, even in your paintings here with what you've been doing. Beautiful.
Thank you. So yeah. And also my medium has changed very recently. This is a mixed media collage, and I kind of use that as my logo. And this one here is all mixed media, and that's on a board. I've done traditional oil paintings, acrylic paintings of dogs, and many other things. But when I started doing the books, I moved into, some of them are traditional mediums, but I moved into digital art, which is the last thing I would ever expect myself to do. I was a traditional medium artist, and now I love it. So again, not standing in my own way of trying something new and finding out that it's a really, and a lot of children's book illustrators are going that way because there's so many things you can do with it that you can't do with traditional art.
So to do digital, help explain to the viewers, like when you're saying digital art from mixed media, when you're using your brush and your canvases and so forth, you go to digital. What does that take? Is that like software? Is that what you have to learn? Teach yourself?
There's software. I would use watching you on the iPad Pro, which is a bigger version of the iPad. So this is a book I'm working on currently, which is Chance to Rescue Stella's Story. So you would take the iPad, and you would use, or another tablet. I mean, it doesn't have to be an Apple. And the pencil, and you get a canvas. This is your canvas. I use a textured surface on here that feels like you're drawing.
Oh, okay.
You can have any colors you want, but this always makes non-artists' eyes glaze over, but you draw on layers. So she'll be on a different layer than he will be, and the fence is on a different layer. And this way, if I want to change her, I don't have to change the whole painting. I'm just working on her. And so it's very easy to make changes in the art and to move things around and decide, well, I want her to move up, move down, move over, go on this page. It's a just totally different way of working. You can make it look, it doesn't have to look like a cartoon like that. In this book, Chance Knows, you know, these dogs are illustrated in a much more pencil drawing, pastel drawing. And this was all done on the...
Oh, I can't wait till we can get into these with the viewers.
Yeah, so...
What I see here and the loveliness of this is your resiliency and your changes and your way to move through all the different ways to do what you love. And sometimes we get stuck in a certain way and we can't imagine that we can do something differently. And look at how easily that's happened, which is inspiring for folks, I think, sitting out there going, maybe I should try that. That's really cool. So you had all this. You have a studio, I imagine, that you work from?
Yeah. Well, the nice thing about the iPad is you can work. There's no setup or cleanup. And you can work anywhere. So it's a very clean, fast, easy medium. So that's another big advantage of it. Otherwise, I'm a very messy artist.
I think that's the fun of it.
Yeah, it can be.
It can be really collage, fun.
So you're
in Bucks County, everybody. That's where she's coming in from. I know with Zoom, people can come in from anywhere. Deborah is in Bucks County with her husband, Greg, and you have the three Goldens. And you did mention that someone's missing today that's not in the show that we hoped. And who is that and why?
Chance, the star of the books, is not here. Chance just has a little, they tell me he's done. He had a little growth on his leg that had to be removed. That was not good looking. And they just said he's out of surgery and recovering nicely, and I'll pick him up later today. But that's another reason why Stella is so out of sorts, because he is considered her mentor dog and she relies on him very heavily to feel secure in the world. And so she noticed right away when he was not here. Well, even though Fizzy gives her confidence as well.
Yeah, let's all pray for a good outcome for Chance.
Thank you. He's doing good, so.
That's hard to keep pushing. So thank you for that. Let's talk now about how you started with your first book. And
so why
Deborah
I say
is
my dog.
So for those of you sitting out there, that's a whole different step. I know she's going to talk about that, like from, oh my gosh, I need to get a big publishing house behind me versus I can self-publish. Again, there's going to be those head bullies that say we can't. And take us through a little journey. I know your first book was published in what, 2018? Chance's Tale. Can you lead us on that? Maybe read some of that too. Well,
okay, so even before Chance's Tale came out.
Oh, okay.
This is from Shutterfly. I don't know if I've been mentioning all these things, but this is because I constantly had people ask, how did Chance become a therapy dog? Is that the same as a service dog? And people had a lot of questions when we would go into schools and the library. And to my mom's retirement home, and people had so many questions. So I was like, you know, I'm going to write this down. So one night, you know, I got on the computer and I got a bunch of pictures and I wrote the story. My mom was so happy that she got the story.
Oh, there's mom.
Rest in peace, mom. And this worked. So I said, well, you know what? This would be neat if I actually made a book. And this is where the debut of the, I just got the Apple Pencil, which I did not really like, and because I have to learn the software. But then what I did is I took the story, I refined the story, but then I started adding cartoon Chance.
Ah.
So it's the same story, but now the cartoon comes in. Because one thing I like, you know, I love art, I love telling stories, and I love making people laugh.
So
hopefully these, you know, I always put in these things, and so now I get to play with this cartoon Chance, and he's making comments. Even though he's telling the story is written in first person Chance. He's also making commentary as we go. So this is my first experience using the digital medium, just in the software that comes on the iPad before I bought the app. Which the app I use, that professionals use, it's only $10. You know, it's not like you have to spend hundreds of dollars to get this application.
Interesting.
And yeah, so that's how I was able to do so much more now. But that's where that digital art form started for me as well, with Chance's Tale, how I became a therapy dog.
What a beautiful cover on that. And I can see from the title, how I became a therapy dog, and then it's crossed out a tail instead of the tail. Can you read a little section since it's coming from his voice? I think a lot of people struggle with it. Does it come from the dog's voice when I write, or should it come from me? How does he start out to help people understand therapy dogs and what he does there?
Well, I'm going to read this one page because this is, I think, important when I read to the children. So reading this page here, and it says, we'll back up one.
Yeah, give us a background.
We'll go back a little bit. So he says, all right. So I started acting like a therapy dog. And there he is. My mom didn't even like dogs, but she had no choice because I just plopped him on her lap. But then she took great pride in that everybody else loved him. So she's like, yes, this is my grand dog. So she took great joy in that. I started acting like a therapy dog right away by visiting my mom, who had an operation and was working on getting well. Therapy dogs bring love, make people smile, and can help people keep people calm, can help calm people down when they are upset, right? And then I will be different from a service dog, such as a dog that helps someone who cannot see. A service dog must be allowed to go everywhere. It is the law. And I'm also hoping to write a book explaining all the different things that dogs can do. And I have Dog at Work. And this says, and again, I like to put what I call little Easter eggs in my books too. If nothing else, they amuse me. And this dog's name is Philly. And it says, see Philly special, work best. So Philly special.
Oh, very cute.
You know, and this was when the Eagles won the Super Bowl.
Very cute. Yeah.
And Maggie is a 3-year-old and has diabetes. Her dog, Philly, is a diabetic alert dog that helps Maggie keep safe. And that is the granddaughter of one of my friends. And got this service dog at 3 years old, one of the youngest people to get a service dog. So that's where I make a little bit of differentiation. And then it says, to be a real therapy dog, I had to go to school. Can you believe that? I tried eating the papers for puppy kindergarten, but that did not work. I think my mom changed my name to Bad Boy. And the kids get a kick out of that because he literally ate the papers for kindergarten. And they think it's funny that it's a little devil there. And then he plays with the other dogs and he likes it. And then this, I think, is an important message. He goes, I had to take other classes and pass the canine good citizen test. Canine means good. Passing the test means I'm a good dog. I had to take the test 3 times.
Oh, that's cute.
I can tell you that it's okay not to get something right the first time. Sometimes you need to practice.
Very nice.
I tried to put, you know, without being preachy, I probably put nice messages in the books.
Yes. And in this one,
he is in a race and he comes in 2nd place. So I am number 2. And it turns out he doesn't even like to chase tennis balls. It was for the Puppy Olympics, fastest retriever on the lake. And I don't even like tennis balls. I just like the other puppies. There were only 2 dogs in the ring.
No, that's very cute. And that's okay. Yeah.
So, so then explains how he got from there, and then the different things that he does and the places that he goes
in his therapy work.
Has
Chase been doing therapy work since with COVID? We have to do it from the outside. I didn't know if
he has not. Some of my friends who do it have done the parades, the puppy parades.
Okay.
He has not. The places that we go to and the schools, obviously,
right now
have been closed down. And yeah.
But you did say you were comfortable with Zoom because you did do a Zoom reading, did you not, to some children with some of your books?
We did through one group that he is in, Roxy Therapy.
Okay.
They asked if we would read books to the children. And at that point, I did have all 3. Sat with me for most of the time, and we read one of his books.
Oh, that's lovely.
Videoed it and did a video and sent that in. So,
oh, that's lovely.
That would be the only work he did do during this time.
So yeah. And you would say children, I had asked you before, when you're writing a book or you're conceiving of a book, do you have to sit there and think about what age group? Wow, is this a read aloud to this age group? Is it a read to themselves, this age group? How do you approach that? Being a teacher and an educator, I'm sure it's kind of intuitive for you, but do you have to worry about that?
Sometimes? I don't know that it's that intuitive to me, since I was not an elementary classroom teacher. Okay. I taught all the grades. So I do try to think of like what grade level would read this. Obviously, when I do an ABC book, I'm thinking of the younger kids, although the last ABC book I did has larger vocabulary in it. But I'm getting very good feedback from parents and teachers on that, that, you know, yeah, we don't want A's for Apple, B's for Ball anymore.
Yeah, let's get into that one. Can we go to that book next, or would you like to pick one first before that?
I'll go to Chance Knows.
Okay.
So this one's written a little bit higher level, I would say, no less than second grade. But, you know, it's hard to say reading level because every child is different. And it's also based on interest. But this one definitely second, third, maybe in fourth grade would enjoy this. But Chance Knows How to Treat Dogs. And again, I write translated and illustrated by Deborah Deeken. So again,
that's clever.
Narrating. So my name is Chance, and I know some things that you should know about your dog and other dogs too. And getting a dog isn't like getting a toy or present. You can't give us away if something goes wrong with us or we get old. He says, I know. We need you to care for us and love us our entire lives. We want to be your best friend. We want to love you and be loved by you forever.
Perfect.
Words. And again, this was all done digitally. Okay. And then lots of little jokes. I'm a golden retriever, so why is everyone calling me husky? And the scale says way too much. Under here saying, I'll get you, rubber ducky. I'll just skip around a little bit. We need to get a bath sometimes, but not as often as you. Keep us clean and dry and brush our hair. So what I found is a lot of, when he would be in school, a lot of the children were reading books to him about dogs. And some of them were very dry if they were just informational. And they were not always, I don't think, that accurate. So when I wrote this book, I had two dog trainers actually go over it with me and make sure I had good information. And say, oh, make sure you tell them this, make sure you tell them that, also tell them that. I have one part here. I have here all the foods. This is about, I know that dogs are afraid of things such as thunder, fireworks, vacuum cleaners, and your electronic toys. And it's such a shame that so many dogs are really petrified of fireworks and people don't get that. Some dogs are scared of strangers and children. This might seem silly to you, but if you have ever been afraid, you know how bad that feels. So trying always to try to connect with, you know, how children might feel. Yeah. Have you ever been afraid? Well, dogs get afraid too. And we need you to comfort us and make us feel safe, keep us away from certain things. And here's an example of foods that dogs aren't safe for dogs. That dogs, how and where they don't like to be touched. Now it's a little bit different, I say, with a therapy dog, but most dogs wouldn't like this.
Oh, the pictures and illustrations are so nice. Yeah. So happy.
You wouldn't bother a service dog. All right. What to do with a strange dog. You see that one?
Yeah.
I know if a playful dog jumps on you, just quietly turn away. If a strange dog comes near you, turn your back. Be like a tree and stand still. Even if you're scared, never ever run from a dog. And he says, I'm a tree. And the big happy dog says, I'm excited to see you. And the little dog says, I'm a dog you don't know or trust.
Yes. Okay.
And then this one says, we can learn to be good dogs without you ever having to scare, hit, or hurt us. We have feelings too. When someone hurts a dog, sometimes the dog bites back.
Uh-huh. So, very nice. Very nice.
Yeah. And just things like a wagging tail isn't always, you know, that's called the tail of the tail.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the tail of the tail, folks.
My trainer was like, well, actually, that tail would be a little bit more like that, a little bit more like that.
Oh, I hope children are watching today for all of these things.
And the last one, I'll just show you. It's really informative. This one, you know, the dog doesn't like to be hugged. A lot of dogs really dislike that. And I say in there, maybe you don't like to be hugged either. You know, not everybody likes. Mm-hmm. Right now, we can't even hug. Yeah, that I do miss. But the half moon eyes, the ears pinned back, the licking the nose, these are all signs. You know, we don't listen to our dogs. Dogs do talk to us. Mm-hmm. We need to learn to listen. So I think this is a really good book for children who learn, you know, they're being taught, oh, put your hand, you know, put your hand up to the dog's nose. No.
Yes. Yes. Not,
no.
Yeah. So, and you always seem to relate it to how children might also be feeling through that book.
That's what I try to do, yeah.
I don't always say, just like you, they're a sentient, you know, they have these feelings.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, and I have the one where the space bubble, that dogs have a personal space bubble, just like people.
Oh, that's clever. Yeah. Yeah.
Kids can relate to that.
Excellent.
So the most recent one is Chance Knows His ABCs. Because I do have another ABC book, which was written in a entirely different, this is all hand-painted paper collage. And
did this come first?
This is one of my first ones. And this one, in the style, I'm not comparing myself to Eric Carle, but in the style that he hand-painted all of this paper and cut collage, that's all, this is hand-painted paper. So if I did this page, I painted all the different papers for those colors.
Wow.
And then I did add some oil pastel into them. But, and then, you know, it was funny because I had some teachers say, well, you are going to have a narwhal in there, right? You've got to have a unicorn, right? And so there are certain things that kids, what about a vampire bat? You're going to have a vampire bat, right? Because my niece teaches first grade. So she gave me some hints on some things that ought to be in there.
So this says
U is for unicorn, but they are not real. V is for vampire bat, out for a meal. And then there's little quips in there, like, you are not very nice, I really want to suck your blood. And then the kids can go in and, like, can you find a U in there? Find the U's, and can you find V's? And then they'll go, oh, I can find a P and an O and an I and an R, however you want to play. Because I have three grandnephews, so I want to write ABC books. But I like my Chance series, so if your Chance should have an ABC book, and so then we have a little play where we have all the dogs.
They're all dogs. They're all dogs.
Making
very clever.
Letters.
Very clever.
So I introduce Chance, and then we introduce, this is where Stella makes her debut. And so she explains that she's a rescue dog and people didn't treat her that well. And then Kizzy, 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 Kizzy.
There's Kizzy.
Yeah. Aww. Hard thing with this one was I started when I first got her. And as I'm writing, she's growing. And the pictures keep growing. I'm like, oh, I got to go back and redraw this.
Oh, yeah. She didn't stay consistent. Huh?
Yeah, she didn't stay little. And then these are some of our friends. So what I like to do, these are all dogs of people I know. So I like to do that.
Yes, yes, all kinds.
Makes it more fun for me to draw them. So we have things like A is for appreciation. I feel thankful for a meal shared with friends. B is for believing in yourself. I know I will be a service dog one day. School that. The dogs go to raise service dogs for veterans. C is for curiosity. All right. We really want to know what this is. So then they explain what each one is. And let's get to some. Oh, I like D. D is for diversity. All right. We are all different, but we are all friends. I'm a golden retriever. I'm a pit bull. I'm a border collie.
Mm-hmm.
And there, this one's going to be appropriate for today because Chance is going to come home in a cone.
Oh,
Chance, I felt sad when I had to wear this collar too. And then she says, it's okay, Mom will take it off when your boo-boo is better. And Pizzy says, is that a lampshade on your head?
Oh, very, very cute. Yeah, the words that you're using in here, while the concepts can work for anyone, and they are bigger words. Normally in an ABC book, you'll see one syllable words, I think, and now you're using words that they can understand when they hear them with a description and a picture, which is right.
Hardworking, imagination, justice, kindness, leadership, manners, nurturing, open-minded, responsibility, tolerance, unique.
Unique, okay, all right.
I'll show you unique. Unique's really
good. Yeah, that's unique. You know, the ending letters were always a challenge. So let's see what we
came. Yeah, some of them were really a challenge.
Those were challenging.
Okay.
I know you came up
with. I am one of a kind. There is no other puppy like me.
Oh.
And it says Pizzy here, but then it's like, oh, or me, or me, or me, or me, or me, or me. Because right? We're all unique, right?
Oh, very nice. Very nice. Very
a lot of fun.
Clever. And what was the Z?
Z is for zest for life.
Oh, excellent. Excellent.
And she says, I enjoy playing ball in the yard of my
home. In the yard of my home. Oh, that's excellent. Zest. Great. Oh, that's
what about X? X is for X Factor.
Oh.
Special talent is why I won the egg hunt.
Okay. Very, very creative. Yeah, very creative. And you had these self-published and
yes.
We'll talk about how people can find them. Should we? I love these books. I told you, I'm so charmed. I think the whimsicality and the concepts and the positivity speak to everybody. Let's see, then which did you go to next? You want to talk about, let's see. Did you want to touch on your Black Cloud Day because of now? Even though I guess there's no dog, so it's up to you.
Oh, that's up to you. I'll mention this one. The Leader Horse to okay. Water one was cute because this was while I was still teaching. I was interviewing first graders.
Oh, this is the parables, so the proverbs.
The proverbs. I would say,
oh,
you
need yes.
Horse to water, but you can't make them. And they would say, swim. So then I would make these silly collages when I went home. So this was what last year I was teaching. And then I over here, I put the correct answer and then I explain what it means because I found even kids who knew the correct answer couldn't really tell you what it meant. So, yeah, so these just have a lot of silly pictures. A lot of times I do dogs in the pictures because I have, like, there's a dog. All right. And it says, you can't teach an old dog new math or to play checkers. Well, again, there's some of the whimsical dogs.
Very clever. And then that's very clever. And they're using that. Do they use these in schools at all? Have these been
this one was popular the last school I went to with the fourth grade because they do it.
Oh.
So this was popular with the fourth graders.
Okay. Excellent.
And then my other most recent is called Black Cloud Day. Having a really, lousy week. I was like, well, what does that look like for a little kid? And I also wanted to do one other than the introduction so that if your parent opens this up, you don't know what it's about. And it says, do you ever have a day when nothing seems to go right, when everything that can go wrong does go wrong? It's like you're under a black cloud. That happens sometimes. Having people who care about you can get you through a black cloud day. And here's the little dog with its head in the cereal box and the cat eating all the cereal. And so a nice little quote from Dolly Parton, if you see someone without a smile, give them one of yours.
Oh, yeah.
But excuse me, the only really words in the story are, did you ever have a black cloud day? This is really good for reluctant readers. It's really good for making inferences and for story starters, because that's really where the story starts. In general, mm-hmm. Black Cloud Day.
I see.
And then this little girl, everything goes wrong, gets out of bed, breaks the calculator, and it's just going to go from there. cereal, no cereal, and just everything's going to go wrong.
Late.
This is the bus, late for school, and then the friends come along. And she tells them what's wrong, and they're going to help her out. And this was nice when I presented this, having the kids, like, what do you think they're going to do? You know, what, she couldn't find a matching shoe. And they actually got this.
Look at that.
They're going to switch shoes because they're used to mixed match day.
They're
like, oh, they could all have mixed match shoes. So they actually got that before.
They got that on their own.
So, well, the cat was sick, you know, and you can't fix that. So you can't fix everybody's problem, but you can just be there for them. So, you know, that goes on, and then it ends with, you know, did you know black cloud days, they last forever.
And there goes the clouds. Excellent. Yeah. That's so timely for today. That's great.
I think so.
And your inspiration to do these things comes to you from even with that one. Was it teachers, people in the professions telling you this was going
on? That one, just, I was having a really, really bad week. And just was like, wow, you know, what would that look like?
If you were a child.
If you were a child. And just, again, that one just decided, just wanted to do it without words. What would it look like, and what would it look like without words? Could I do that?
Excellent.
Again, even though it looks like a, you know, pencil drawing, it's again done on the iPad.
Oh, the concept comes right there. Oh my goodness, yes.
And then when I need a person, the teacher here, when they have to go, she has to go to the teacher and tell her that she doesn't have her homework. That's a friend of mine.
Okay. Oh, so, nice. Nice.
Mrs. Johnson is a friend of mine.
Very nice. Very useful in dialoguing. Yeah, that's great. That's awesome. What's next for you? What are we like? Where's that creative spirit going now? What's happening now?
Well, as far as the books.
Yeah, or art, or.
Well, the art. Can I grab these?
Yeah. Go. Oh.
Well, I did show you earlier just playing around, and I'm just playing with some art. This is just called an artist book. This isn't something you publish. This is just something I was in a printmaking class, and we made prints out of what's called jelly plates. And I just decided my book would be all about
adorable. Yeah.
It's just, you know. It's just whimsical and playful, and I don't know, maybe my nephews will like to look at it someday.
Yeah, you know. Very fun.
So that's that. And that's the original, and that's mixed medium. It's collage paper. So these are pieces of paper, and then I paint over it, and I wipe it off, and I just put matte medium, and I paint it, and I wipe it off, and I paint it, and wipe it off.
Wow.
And so that's called my GQ Golden. And then
GQ.
This one's GQ.
Yeah.
And this one's inspired by Stella. This is called From Puppy Mill to Princess. I call her my princess.
Do you want to talk a little about the puppy mills, and or do you want to kind of not?
But it was. Yeah, I'll show you a little bit about her book. I can do that.
Yeah.
This one is a print from the one behind me. This is all letters cut out of a magazine, D-O-G, all over and over again.
Oh.
Yeah, and that one's called Fetch. And, you know, I've used that type of imagery
That's
other places. Cool. This is Smokin' Hot Lab. Seeing Spots.
Yeah.
This is just playing around. This is Stands Out from a Crowd.
Oh my.
Using an old photograph in the background.
Oh my goodness. Deborah, you're so creative.
Easy Rider.
What is that one called?
Easy Rider.
Oh my gosh.
And Cool Hot Dog. No, I'll stop with this one. This one is called Love is Blind. And this one I saw a story on Facebook or YouTube, and a rescue group got called, a guy from a junkyard called a rescue group, and he said, there's this dog under a car, you know, can you come get him? He goes, I need him out of my junkyard. So they come get this black dog from out from under the car, and he's old and he's blind, and the vet says, you need to put this dog down. They're like, we can't. This dog needs to be loved before his life ends. Turns out it's not even a black dog. It was like a tan colored dog. He was just so covered in filth and grease and dirt. So they wash him all up and they start loving him up, and he was just the happiest thing. And so he got to live out whatever.
That's awesome. Is that a group you're working with? Is that what you're talking
about? No, I just saw that on YouTube, and it just inspired me to make that print.
Were you showing us note cards there? Is that what that was?
These are archival prints.
Five by seven prints.
We have them covered in here. So these can be framed. You know, this is just larger because it's
okay.
But they can be mounted and framed. So Stella is, I'm working on a book, how do you teach children about puppy mills, you know, in a somewhat gentle way, right? So the book I'm currently working on is called Chance to the Rescue, Stella's Story, because big part of, and I do have some end matter at the end of the book where if your little kid's going to get to that and go, too much words, and some kids will go, I will read this, and hopefully the parents will read it, get some education that way. But Chance is what's called the mentor dog. And so he says, yay, I have a new sister. Mom and dad adopted her from a rescue group. Her name is Stella. Stella means star. We hope she'll shine in her new life with us. The rescue group says Stella was very shy around people and didn't like to be touched yet. Now, these drawings aren't necessarily finished. You're getting a little teaser here.
Yeah, we're getting a teaser. I'm very excited.
We are. When we met Stella in the yard, we played as we had been best friends forever. Stella will need a family who has time and patience and a mentor dog, a confident dog to help her. And that's my job. Big brother. And that's supposed to be Blurry because they're running. Big brother and mentor. That's me.
Very nice.
And then I'll show you this one because it's funny. All right. Leaving the rescue, Stella trembled when she had to get in the crate. She was so scared she made a mess in our van. Did someone fart? And Chance says that wasn't a fart. Then he says, we will all need to be patient.
Very good. Very good.
So it goes on, and I need to put the thumbnails here. He explains, you know, what it was like for him growing up as a puppy. And then what I'm working on right now is her explaining there's going to be an X over that. That wasn't for me. And then that's about as graphic as I'm going to get with.
Yes, it is. It comes through. Absolutely.
And then it shows what had to go and then when she changes. And not only is it a book about puppy mills, it also kind of parallels, unfortunately, what a lot of children get, you know, a bad hand in life. And then they get, you know, hopefully adopted maybe is what they need, or they get a soft place to land in school. They get the right teachers. And they can, their life doesn't have to be bad. So Stella's story is also a lot of, unfortunately, a lot of children's story too. When teachers heard that story, they're like, you need to write that story because kids, a lot of kids will resonate with them.
Wow. So that's a timely one.
Yeah.
Unfortunately. Still are running. You know, running full bore and with children, you know, with issues. So timely. Excellent. Yeah. And
trying to get that word out about the mills, because I think a lot of people just don't know.
They still don't know. And they still have trouble identifying a broker house for puppy mills online, websites that look beautiful and here we have these dogs, and behind all of it is not good.
Just when they see Stella's behavior, how terrified, like when I walk them, she just steers clear of people, and they're like, oh, she's shy. And anybody who will listen a little bit, you know, and I start telling them, they want to know. And I mean, they're only seeing the after effects. They're not seeing the horrible, grungy, disgusting condition.
Yes, yes.
Stella was fortunate in that when she went into season, something happened. We don't know if she, you know, had miscarriage, or we don't know what happened. The smaller mills will turn them over, but won't give too much information. So she was only there for a year or so, and probably did not deliver any puppies. So I thought, oh, well, she, because I did all my research, I knew what I was getting into. And I had a good friend who fostered dogs like Stella. And so I knew it was going to be difficult. It was the hardest thing I ever did. She's the hardest dog I've ever loved, and I love her so much. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if they're in a mill with 10 dogs or 500 dogs. It doesn't matter if they're there a year or 5 years. They do not get that human imprinting when they're puppies. And this is what happens to them, you know. So when people rescue a dog, you're like, oh, I don't know what happened to him. I know what happened to her. And so they have very specific characteristics. They're going to be afraid of people. They're going to be afraid of doorways. They're going to, you know, have very specific things. They're not going to know where to go to the bathroom. They don't know how to walk on a leash.
Right.
You know, if God help you, if they are to get away from you, they're not coming back. They will freeze or starve before they will ask for help.
They don't know toys. They don't know joy. They don't know.
That's in the book. They do not know. He piled, I already showed it off, he piled toys up on her bed.
Oh.
Every night. And she just looked at him. And she loves other dogs. Absolutely loves other dogs. Oh. And she just looked at him like, I don't know what you're talking about. So every day he piled toys up on there, and he goes, because I even called the rescue. I said, what's her favorite toy? I want to get it and have it here for her. And they go, she doesn't play with toys.
No.
And so she's saying, I don't know how to play. And then I pile up toys on her bed every day to try to get her play. And then one day she played tug of war with me, and she wagged her tail too. You know? And I just remember how excited I was the first time she wagged her tail.
Yeah.
I mean, things you just expect from a dog.
And especially a golden retriever.
A golden retriever. The first time she jumped up on me, oh my gosh, it was probably a good maybe 8 months after I had her. And I was like, oh my gosh, that is so bad. We'll work on that later.
Uh-huh.
And to this day, she's the only one who's allowed to jump up on me. Because it's such a natural thing for dogs to do, but she was always like, you know, doing that, you know. But, you know, around here, she is, now she's silly and happy. And if you were to see her in the yard, you wouldn't know. And then if you came into the yard, you would know, because, you know, stranger danger. And she'd
get,
But she's getting used to a few people. I have a few friends who can actually pet her now. Two trainers and like two friends. That can pet her. And
my husband,
and that's it. It's a small world for her. It's a
small world. That's okay. She's safe with you and happy. That's awesome. So that book for Stella will be coming out. What do you think? Do you have a goal, or do you know when you might get that done?
I feel like since, you know, quarantine, it's like, oh, I should have written 10 books while I was in quarantine. I didn't. Watch a lot of Netflix. I don't know. It's very close to done. The story's pretty tight, and I only have, I think, 3 drawings that I have to do, or 2 that I haven't started really at all from. And then I'll go back, and then just like the writing, you're always polishing, I'll go back into the drawings and keep polishing. But it won't be too long. And then I'm also working on a coloring book for the ABC book.
Okay. That's awesome. So very busy, very prolific, very creative. Your mind is spinning, I'm sure, a lot of times. It's exciting. It's exciting what you've done and what you continue to do to help bring My Dog Made Me Do It into your whole life path, which is just bad. Fantastic.
I'm enjoying it. I really enjoy it. And I enjoy, before this all happened, yeah. I was going into the schools and talking with the children, which is something I still enjoy doing, and doing presentations. And either Chance or Kismet was coming in with me, and, you know, kids love dogs. And, you know, I had different presentations based upon the grade level that I was speaking to. And just a lot of fun. So I miss doing that as well. But again, so I still like spreading messages and humor and anything I can educate about dogs. But I also, again, try to put other just good life messages in there. And yeah, I have a few other dog books up my sleeve.
I bet you do. How can people, I'm sure we've piqued their interest, Deborah, to find you, find your books, purchase some books. How can all that happen?
Well, I sell them privately because to sell them on, and I'm changing publishing companies right now because of some overhaul on their part. The prices would be too high if I have to put them through, you know, if I sell online.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So I try to keep the prices as low as I can. So it would be through my either my Facebook page. I have a Deborah Deeken Art Facebook page.
Let's spell that out, huh? Deborah Deeken, D-E-B-O-R-A-H, folks. D-E-E-K-E-N, Art on Facebook.
Yeah, so that's my public Facebook page, or Deborah Deeken Art at gmail.com is my
email.
Email address.
Okay.
And so people just contact me, and you know, local people, I just give it to them. Otherwise, I mail. I did a lot of mailing of Chance's ABC book, has done very well already. So I mail them out. And
yeah, we want more people to be able to get these books and share. It's awesome.
So for, you know, for a small author who's just on my own, I did hit my 500 book mark. So that was pretty good for a year and a half. Without any mass marketing. So
yeah excellent. So I think, is there any other final thoughts you'd like to share? This has been so much fun for me, and I hope that the viewers have had a blast.
I wish the dogs would have chimed in a little bit more.
Yeah, where are they? My Charlie's asleep too. I think it's a rainy sleepy day. It's a rainy sleepy day.
Come here. Oh, big stretch. Come on. There we go.
Oh, there's Kismet.
There we are.
What a good puppy. 10 months old. Very calm. Hi, Kismet.
Can you say hi? You're not looking at the camera. There's Stella.
Camera's guy. Aw. Well, it's been a delight to have all of you on the show.
Yeah, well, I appreciate being here.
Thank you so much.
Sharing some messages.
Yeah. Yeah.
And have to get out there when things open up a bit. There she is.
Maybe we can have an event at this shop. That would be lovely.
Oh, that would be cool. Yeah.
We can do something fun together. That would be so good to bring people together and share your books.
Thank you.
We'll stay in touch.
Okay, very good, Barb. Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome, Deborah. And I think at the end now, I just want to give some final thoughts to folks on how to keep up with some of the COVID and pet issues, just to find good information. I think it gets very confusing out there for families if there's something they need to know differently that the CDC or the VMA has presented. So I'm going to show some of those links. I hope that you all stay safe and well, and keep loving those pups, and good luck to Chance.
Okay, thank you so much, Barb.
You are welcome, Deborah. Have a great day.
Okay, you too. Bye-bye.
All righty, bye-bye. through it as much as I did. I'm also always about people, again, finding their passion through their dogs. And next thing you know, you're on a different path. And a lot of good messages there for today in today's world. And the thing I want to leave you with, as I mentioned, was just to remember that, you know, we're all trying to keep up with current information with this pandemic. And there can be some confusion about being able to transmit back and forth. So I just want to remind you of some websites to be sure that you know that contracting this from pets is not happening. So, you know, we just want to present some of these websites. If the station can put them up, there are three that I recommend you check in with and just stay current and help pass solid, good information. So maybe Joan, if you can put that link page up, that would be terrific. Thank you. And also, you know, always be aware, like if you needed your veterinarian right now to know what their practices are and their procedures, most are all doing contactless from the car and there are procedures to follow. So be sure that you know for your particular veterinarian how to handle that should you need it. And also the emergency areas that you can go to. If you do, there is one locally, Berks Emergency. And of course, down in Malvern, there is VRC, Veterinary Referral Center, and Hope Veterinary Specialty. So be aware of those things. Be just like with your children or yourself. Where can we go when we need help and how does it work? Everybody's trying to follow the guidelines and stay safe through this. And boy, it's sure time to be with your dogs, with your pets at home. There are many great adoptions happening right now, and some folks are getting puppies. Of course, the natural worry is then if things go back to normal and people aren't home with them, you know, we've got to be aware of how to get through these weeks, teaching them, our dogs and our new animals in the home, how to be alone at home. So reach out to your trainers. They're there for you. Most are not doing any classes right now, but be aware, if we're a community business, we welcome that. We have our specialist here, the training manager. We're here to answer those calls. We want you to get the help you need. And as soon as we can, we're going to be out there providing the training and providing the services you need. All right, folks. So stay safe, stay well, hug those pups. And we're going to have to say goodbye. We'll be back next month with another lineup of great guests. Thanks again for tuning in. My name is Barb Emmett. Be safe. Bye-bye.
Dog is Family on Berks Community Television is underwritten by Answers Pet Food.